Hi, Wine Club members. Today I'm here to talk about a ready-to-drink Barolo, which is in the mixed pack and the Barolo and Barbaresco pack. I think this is probably the Barolo that's the most ready to go. So I just want to tell you a couple of quick things about this winery and about this particular wine. So first things to talk about, the winery Claudio Boggione is one of the smallest in all of the Barolo area. I think I need a little bit more wine. I'm a little low right now. What makes Boggione so unique is that they only make Barolo. I know I mentioned this on the tasting notes. It's really unusual that a winemaker would only grow Nebbiolo to make Barolo. And what else is unique is that this is coming from the very famous crew of Brunate. You may have heard this crew when talking about famous names like Vuarzio, Odero, Rinaldi, Giuseppe Rinaldi, Francesco Rinaldi. So Brunate is very well known, and most of the time it's coming from La Mora.
Okay, so here is the map of the crews of Barolo with all 11 villages. Over to the left extreme we have La Mora. Down here we have Barolo village. Brunate is one of the most important crews that we have, more thought of as coming from La Mora, because you go down this road where they have the famous colorful chapel and you see this blue crew is Brunate. So it goes down the hill. And then when you get to this line here, this becomes the comune or the town of Barolo, which then leads by Conubi into Barolo. So this is coming from a very small portion in this little part of this crew Brunate. It's a unique crew because it goes into from La Mora into Barolo.
Another thing I want to talk about is actually the vintage. So 2014 would generally not be my first choice or many people's first choice for a vintage to choose for a Barolo because it was a really unusual year. Because we had a very warm early spring, and then all of a sudden, June, July, August, when it should be really hot, we had severely cold temperatures, lots of rain. I'll never forget. So because of this dampness, it was hard to get in the vineyard. It was all muddy all the time. The vines needed some sunlight. The grapes needed sun. Luckily for Nebbiolo, because it is last to ripen, so a typical harvest for Nebbiolo, for Barolo, would be around mid-October. We had a really key, warmer, drier September and October. So Nebbiolo had more hang time, it had time to ripen, and the Barolos are turning out to be fantastic if they were in lucky sight. And he was very happy that I chose 14 to prove to the world that you could drink a really excellent Barolo, maybe a little bit more ready to drink. And kind of defy all of these stereotypes of the 14 being considered a terrible vintage, a vintage to avoid. So it's really symbolic, and I hope that you agree, and I hope that you find and reconsider that 2014 can be a really good vintage, especially coming from, I would say, talented winemakers. So this proves even more why Claudio Boggione is such a great winemaker. He's so small. This is his only wine that he makes, so he was really, really able to go and look at every single grape bunch and choose just the healthiest, best grape. So I just really, there's a special place in my heart for this wine because it's a 14, and I really hope that you like it. It's so smooth, it's so fruity, so juicy. I just think it would be a great wine to open this weekend. Cheers, and all the best. Remember, now I have a hashtag Barolo Wine Club and an Instagram tag Barolo Wine Club. So share your experiences drinking our wines together. Chin chin.